Hello, I'm Teacher July and I'm back to see you again. Today I'm going to talk about how to do live lessons using StreamYard. If you like the tips that I share in this video, click on the like button down there and subscribe to my channel. I like to share educational sites and programs for teachers like me feeling a little overwhelmed but trying to figure out how to manage remote class due to COVID-19. Usually, I give students assignments so they can study asynchronously. However, from time to time, I feel the urge that I want to go live and communicate with my students in real time, say hello to them, see their responses right away. To do that, I searched for live streaming applications, and voila, I found it, StreamYard. At first, I've tried OBS Studio to go live, but it didn't work. Simply, my computer at school is somewhat outdated and it's not powerful enough to go live with OBS Studio. OBS Studio is a really good program, detailed and sophisticated, though it's kind of heavy and can also be daunting to the beginners like myself. Whereas StreamYard is cloud-based, which means StreamYard servers do most of the work instead of my computer. And one of the greatest things of this StreamYard, it's really easy. Even me, not a techy YouTuber, can go live. I'll show you how easy it is walking you from the start. Okay, the first thing that you have to do is go to StreamYard.com here and create an account. I already have an account, so I will just click login here. But if you don't have it, just write your email address here and click this Get Started button. Okay, login. Okay, I will write my email, get login code. So every time they will send you a code via email. So you don't need a password. So I go to my mail and oh yes, I got a mail, right? And there is a code. Copy it and paste it and log in. Okay, now I'm in the StreamYard. The first thing that you have to do is go to destination. Another destination here. Click this one. I already have my YouTube channel edit up here, but if you click this one, then you can see Twitch and YouTube or Facebook. That destination means that social platforms that you can send your live, right? And one of the greatest features of this StreamYard that you can simulcast from the StreamYard. That means you can go live at YouTube and Twitch and Facebook at the same time, right? Okay, so go to broadcast here. Okay, now you are in broadcast session. So create a broadcast button here, and you can see your channel here. Just click it and write your title. So just test 2 and description of your stream. And you have to set up the privacy level. As a teacher, I recommend you to go unlisted. That means, which means the people that have the link can only watch the stream. And also you can schedule your live stream for later, right? So you can choose the starting time and you can upload your thumbnail image from here. So click on this Create Broadcast button. Now I create my broadcast right here. And okay, let's talk about these three little dots here. Click these dots. So there is invite a guest here, right? You can invite guests to your studio up to 6 by sending this link, right? Copy this and send to them. This is the link not for your viewers, it's just for your guests. If you want to interview someone, bring them to your studio so the viewers can see them from your stream. If some of your students want to be in the stream, then you can send this link to them before the live stream starts. And here is the edit button. You can change your title and description and schedule here. And delete button here. You can just delete your stream if you want. And this view on YouTube, right? It takes you to the link of your stream. So continue to YouTube, right? This is the YouTube link that I will go live. So copy this link and send and share this link with your viewers beforehand so they can see your stream. Okay, let's go ahead. Okay, now we can enter the broadcast studio by clicking it. You can enter the broadcast studio at any time without starting your stream, so don't worry. It's nice that you can prep things beforehand. Okay, enter broadcast studio button here. Oh, hello, right? So cam and mic is working well, so you can see this little green bar is moving. So enter broadcast studio. So this black screen is what viewers actually watch when you go live. So add yourself here so so that you can see you. And now students can see me and hear me if I click this go live button. Okay, let's talk about those sections. Okay, comments, right? The YouTube comments will appear in this section and I can show them on screen by clicking the comment that I choose, and also this banner section. Okay, I made a banner and then you can just click it to show them on screen, right? You can see this banner was like a subtitle. And also you can create your own banner folder beforehand to save your time when you go live. And brand. This means you can change the color and theme, guess like this, right? And guess bigger or smaller the theme. I will not use this logo and overlay and background settings because I'm on a free version. If you are on the premium version, then you'll be able to use them. Okay, private chat section means you can talk with your guests who are inside your studio. Okay, let's move on to share screen button here. If you have two monitors, that makes much easier for you to go live. Okay, you want to share your computer screen, right? Showing students that PowerPoint or Google Slides or YouTube videos, like, so then click it, right? Share screen. I get to choose, so the monitor that what I have to show, and applications, and also browsers. So I will choose this one here, and don't forget to click on this share audio button so the students can hear you, right? Okay, so I add up this cult keys. Okay. Now all you have to do, okay, let's change a bit like this way. Okay, click in this one and then you can change the screen. The students will see like this way, right? Now, all you have to do is click go live button here. Then you can immediately go live. That's all for today's video. That is everything you need to know to go live. I hope this video useful to you. If you found this video helpful, click the like button down there and subscribe to my channel. Good luck with your live lessons. Goodbye.